So in the last class, we were looking at augmented context-free grammars, right? That is context-free grammars which are augmented with features. And these features are actually used for, say, in order to ensure agreement between, say, the subject and the verb and so on. So today, we will be looking at what are known as augmented transition networks. So we had earlier discussed that context-free grammar, an equivalent representation of a context-free grammar, is actually a recursive transition network. Okay, we'd seen that. Now, augmented transition network is actually an equivalent representation for an augmented context-free grammar. Okay, so here, augmented transition network is actually a recursive transition network with features added to it. So again, a recursive transition network is actually, so a recursive transition network is actually equivalent to context-free grammar. We had seen examples of recursive transition networks in earlier classes. Say this is actually an example of a recursive transition network. So this is a recursive transition network for a noun phrase. So if you look at this, you start with this node and you follow this arc when you come across an article, and an article followed by a noun is a noun phrase, or a simple name itself can be a noun phrase. That is what the meaning of this recursive transition network is. Okay. And an augmented transition network is augmented. That is, it augments this particular network with some set of features. Okay. So basically, features in an augmented transition network are called registers. It's only a nomenclature difference. Now, each constituent structure has a set of registers. So here we are talking about, say, this is corresponding to a noun phrase. So each noun phrase will have corresponding set of registers, a corresponding set of features. And as the network is traversed, these registers are set to values by actions associated with each arc. Okay, so this is an example. So here we have got the actual network, and corresponding to each arc, we can associate a set of actions here and as well as a set of tests. So why do we need these tests? Because we said, in addition to checking the structure of a sentence, let us say, in addition to checking the structure of a sentence using a context-free grammar or a recursive transition network, what we want to do is we want to check some conditions also. A typical example is the agreement between subject and verb. So such conditions can be tested, or such constraints can be specified as part of the test. So that is why we have the test corresponding to each arc inside the augmented transition network. And we also associate some actions corresponding to each arc. And these actions actually set the values of the registers. Okay, so again, coming back, we can just review what an augmented transition network is. It is a recursive transition network, and in addition to being a recursive transition network, it has a set of features associated with it. And features are called registers in the case of augmented transition network. And each constituent structure has a set of registers. It is not just for the whole grammar. It is for every constituency. A noun phrase can have a set of registers or a set of features associated with it. And as we traverse this augmented transition network, the registers are set to values by actions. That is what we saw in the example in the next slide. And when the network is popped, that is, when is the network popped? That is when you recognize that particular constituent in the grammar. Okay. So when the network is popped, the registers are assembled to form a constituent structure with the category being the network name. So category in the example which we saw will be a noun phrase. And corresponding to the noun phrase, you will have a set of registers, each of which will have a set of values associated with it. Okay. So that is the idea. So in this example, so we said this is for a noun phrase. So noun phrase can be either an article according to this particular network, the ATN or augmented transition network. A noun phrase can be an article followed by noun. After that, you have a pop arc, and or it could be a name, a proper name. Okay. So when a lexical arc like arc 1 is followed here, the constituent build is stored in a special variable called star. Okay, so what is the action here? So this is actually a feature or a register, and it is assigned star. What star means is it assigns to the feature called determinant of this noun phrase. Whatever is the feature associated with this arc or the article. So there is article is actually a constituent. It has a particular value corresponding to the feature, and that is returned. Current network or current arc, what is the feature value? That is represented using the special variable called star, and that is assigned to the feature called determinant. Okay. So in this case, what is assigned is this art will be assigned to determinant. Okay. Similarly, agreement feature. Okay. Agreement feature for this particular Okay. So now we look at an example how we can parse this particular sentence using the augmented transition network which we have seen. The dog saw Jack. How can we parse this? Okay. So our actual augmented transition network is this. Okay, I'll remove all the arcs first. Okay, so we are going to look at this example, how this is going to be parsed. So our initial input, so we are starting at node S. Okay. That is, we are here first. And the input position is 1. Okay, we are starting at this position, and arc followed arc 4 succeeds. So arc 4 is this, right? Arc 4 actually expects a noun phrase. So when you come across a noun phrase on the arc, what happens? You go back to the network which we have defined here. This is the network for a noun phrase. So you go back here. Okay. And the input is the. Now what happens then? The. So you have to come here and the writing first here. Okay. So now the is encountered. So you came from the original S network to here, and the is an article. So you have to follow this arc. So arc number 1. There is no test, but the determiner for that particular register or the feature will have a value of art is assigned to it. Okay. And the agreement corresponding to this is, so what is the agreement given there? We'll look at it first. Okay, you have gone here, position 1, arc followed is 1. Okay, determinant is assigned a value of the, and the agreement for determinant the is could be either third person singular or third person plural. Okay, so that is the value for determinant, and that is being assigned to, so according to the action here, that set is being assigned to the agreement for the network NP. Okay, this agreement is for the network NP. So for now you follow this up. Now after that, what happens? You have the dog, right? So the dog means so now you have so this there is no test. You have done this action and you have reached NP1. Now you are coming across a dog, so which means you have to follow this arc. So this arc can be followed only if this test is satisfied. So we know the network has got a third person singular and third person plural. Both are there. It could be either of these for the. And in the case of dog, so what is the value? Okay, that will be given here. Second, dog actually will be assigned a singular value, right? It is third person singular. Okay, so the check we do here is, in the case of R2, you have to check third person singular or third person plural corresponding to the, and intersection third person singular. This is wrong. This is third person singular here, right? Because it is a dog. It is singular. So you will have a resultant. So this check actually takes an intersection and the result will be third person singular. Okay, and what is the action corresponding to it? Okay, head will be assigned star. So in this case, it will be this noun, the dog. And the agreement value corresponding to it will be third person singular. Okay, so that is illustrated here in this. So head becomes dog and the agreement value is third person singular. Okay, and then finally you have, you reach NP and position 3 and then you pop. And when you pop, look, it returns the noun phrase, that it is a category, right? And these are the features. Determinant is the, head is a dog, and agreement is third person singular. And that is returned to the original network. So original network means this sentence. So now it traverses this arc. And arc number 4, again there is no test, but what is done, subject of sentence becomes whatever value has been returned here. This is the value returned by the network called noun phrase. So subject is assigned that particular value here. Okay, now subject has been, so this much has been parsed now, right? The dog. Now next is saw. So according to, so we have traversed till here. So next we have to traverse this network when we come across saw, which is a verb, right? Okay, so arc number 5 has to be traversed. So 5 is here. Again, you have got a test here. So, what is the agreement of subject? So what we had is third person singular. And what is the agreement of the verb? That could be third person singular. So this test will succeed. So once it succeeds, what you do, main verb will be assigned saw. Okay, main verb will be, that is again a feature or a register, and the agreement of this will be agreement of subject, which is third person singular, with that of the verb. Again, that value will be third person singular. Okay, so once this arc is followed, that is the action. Now we'll see what happens. So node S1, input position is 3, and arc checks, okay, this is third person singular, errors, okay, again third person singular, look, that is what is assigned here, right? So that is returned. So third person singular and main verb is being assigned, so this much features are ready. Now you have reached this position. Now you have got Jack to be processed. Sorry, Jack to be processed. Okay, so again, we are at S2 and it is this arc which is to be followed. So again, you come across a noun phrase. So again, you go back to this network, right? So, and in this network, we know we are not coming across an article, we have come across a noun, a name itself. Okay, so when we come across a name, it is the arc number 3 that is followed. Here there is no checking, but the name attribute is assigned, what is it? It was Jack, right? The value Jack. and the agreement corresponding to this particular noun phrase is the agreement corresponding to Jack, which might be third person singular, and that is returned. Okay, and where do we come back? In the main network, we come back here. Okay, and in order to traverse that, there are no checks here. We do not have to check because we do not need any agreement checking here, but the object of the sentence is assigned star. Star in this case is the name John. John, not John, Jack. Okay. Now we look at what happens here. Look, we were at S2 and we were at position 4 and we followed arc 6. We did a recursive call here. Here, we come here and we do. Look, name has been assigned John and agreement is third person singular, and then the name the noun phrase network pops, then we return this particular value which is assigned to object of the sentence. And finally, now this particular recursive transition network also has popped, right? So we have successfully traversed. So when we successfully traverse, this particular network will return the whole set of registers. Okay, and that is, so here we have traversed the whole network, and now the sentence network here, the ATN network here, has been successfully traversed, and so it has, the sentence has been parsed successfully. Okay, so this is how we parse an augmented transition network. So I hope you understood what an augmented transition network and how we parse it.